Hi, I'm Joe, Knight ATV Scroy, and this is our Honda Shore 4 manual four-wheel drive conversion kit. Inside the box, you're going to find some paperwork, the manual actuator that replaces your electronic actuator, a plug and some other parts, the plug and the screws that hold your manual actuator on, some O-rings, the tank lever that goes on your handlebars, and some other paperwork. All right, let's go ahead and install it. All right, so the first thing you want to do is remove your electric two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive button. Take out the three screws that hold it on. Remove any gasket that's on there. And then follow the electric wire down. You're going to have to remove some plastics on the front end. And you're going to unplug it. Where you unplug it from, you're going to put this plug that's supplied into where you remove this plug from. Next, we'll install the tank lever. Just like this, install the plug where that wire used to be. So the first thing you're gonna do is put the tank lever in. You're gonna route the cable. The cable goes in front of your steering column, in between your gas tank and your steering column. You can see right here, here's the cable. Okay, it's ran down right here. So make sure that it swoops down nice and smooth and there's no kinks or bends in it. It's specifically designed to move to be installed right here. So that's that. Next, you're going to mount this. You have the gasket that goes in between your tank lever and either your throttle or your electric drive switch. And then the screws that come with your kit are used to mount the tank lever. And that's it, your tank lever is mounted. Next, we will install. First thing, take the lid off of your actuator, and we're going to put the O-rings on. Both O-rings are the same size. The one that goes on the lid, you need to stretch a little bit. It is designed that way. And also the bearing that you see here, you're going to put that inside the lid if it's not already installed. So we'll take these O-rings out. One O-ring goes on the bottom in the groove here. The other O-ring goes on the back of the lid. Stretch that over top of it, just like that. And the O-ring, bearing will go inside the lid and on the actuator like that. Before I install that though, I want to show you how to install the cable. You're going to do this while it's on the bike, but it's a lot easier for me to show you here. So your actuator will get mounted to your differential in this orientation, and your cable will be coming down in this direction from up top. You're going to shift your tank lever into the two-wheel drive position. That will make the cable stick out here. Then you are going to thread your actuator onto the cable. You're gonna actually spin the actuator. That's what I found was the easiest before you mount this onto your differential. Okay, then the cable will bend around like this and drop into the groove right here, like that. And then this nut you can tighten down to lock it, and this slides off. Like that. And then this, you need this to be straight. If this is bent, you're not gonna be able to spin this. So you want this to be straight, and then you can spin this. You see how this rotates on top of this. And that is how you are going to adjust your actuator. So you will shift, after this is done, after your cable is installed, you'll shift into four-wheel drive. And you may need to rotate the wheels on your vehicle a little bit in order to get the gears to slide together. Shift to four-wheel drive, and then you're going to look and make sure that these marks here are in a straight line. Okay? You You see that there?
Yeah.
And you are going to adjust it by rotating this. You see how it's going past the line now as I'm unscrewing it like this. And if I screw it back in, you see how it goes to the other side of the line. So get that set. That's your four-wheel drive position. Put the tank lever in four-wheel drive and then get those to line up. Once you get that lined up, put this lock nut on and your adjustments are done. Tighten these nuts down. Your adjustments are done. Then you'll be able to put the lid on. Then we can come over here and we can see. So down here, the electronic actuator has been removed and the new actuator is installed. These nuts have been tightened and that it was lined up. We adjusted it to make sure it was lined up. The next step, after you removed your electronic actuator, you're going to put the supplied plug into the wire harness where it was unplugged from. Secure that out of the way. And that's it. Your installation is complete. Put your plastics back on and you're ready to ride. Thank you.